Alrighty, we have this fur. Goes up about 35, 40 feet. The top hooks out over here. So I have a gun really high to the left on that red way out there. There's like a fir and a couple, three redwoods. It's that far one. I'm going to try to get it in the little goalpost area right there. My chain's a little hungry, but it's doing okay. Out to be a nice little chain throw on a brand new chain. I mean, that makes perfect sense. We're gonna obliterate the chain right out of the gate. Thank you. Now on a personal level, I always make sure that the inside's pretty spotless, because that's your sealing surface for your oil hole and your bar oil hole interface. I'm sure there's going to be a tooth or two after that that's completely thrashed. Right now, so it's going to be easy to find the tooth, but I don't have my custom file with me at the moment to deal with it. I have my raker file, which I'm super thankful, because the raker file doesn't hurt the bottom of the straps at all. We'll get this thing bucked up and then figure it out, but yeah, that's one way to fix that kind of screw up. up right here, as long as we're dealing with like fixing things. The buck should have been made this way, and then it would allow for the bottom one to fall away. But if I buck it slanted to the left, it becomes tight, as we see. So essentially, if you think about it in concept, this one would possibly drop to this and no more. That one has potential to fall a lot further. So essentially, that's like one of those bucking things that a guy has to be thinking about, as long as we're dealing with complete screw-ups, since through the chain had to fix the drivers. That was kind of a process. But this will be easy to escape from, actually. So we'll see how that works. Alrighty then. So we threw the chain, we saw how to get it on, we found out that the drivers were hammered, so we had to adjust and take out basically the burrs. Sometimes they'll just burn in. I don't like to seriously burn them in. This one wasn't doing anything, so we saw how to fix that. Then we just watched what we need to do when we're talking about considering what's happening with the bucking. It's all kinds of stuff we're learning today. So thanks for watching this session, wherever you might be on.